This is our first speaker, Pastor Bola Akomolafe.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, we thank the Lord for bringing us here today. Mm-hmm. I thank the Lord for my sister that organized the program. And I pray that God will continue to be with you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I thank the pastor of the house. Mm-hmm. And I also thank you for calling me to come and speak on this occasion. I don't take it for granted. I say thank you. Amen.
Amen.
And God will give us the grace to do more of it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And whatever we are going to learn here today, we take it home and we start using them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And on the last day, we will sit, we will be with Jesus, and all of us will see God.
Amen.
And we will all get our crown.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We will not do the work for vain. Father, we thank you once again.
You.
Let your name be glorified.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Sorry, I did an IVG.
Oh.
So, and I'll be here for long anyway. But we thank the Lord.
Amen.
God will continue to strengthen all of us.
Amen.
It's His work.
Amen.
It's because of Him we are living.
Yes. Yes.
So whatever we are doing for Him is not too much.
Mm-hmm.
It's not even enough.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
My topic this morning. We know that. Sorry. We know that our top, what we are doing today is the vessel of honor, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. And God will make all of us to be vessel of honor unto Him in Jesus'
name. Amen.
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 When you are vessel of honor, God will use you.
Amen.
That is why we have to present ourselves to be vessel of honor before Him. Amen.
Amen.
When you present yourself, He will use you. Shall we pray? Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you once again, Lord.
Amen.
We exalt you.
Amen.
Father, we are praying for this little time we are going to, you're going to use me to speak to your people. Father, speak through me.
Amen.
Not what I prepared, but what you want them to hear.
Jesus.
Father, do it, Lord.
Amen.
Take over.
Amen.
And let your name be glorified.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Praise God.
Hallelujah.
The Lord will make us a vessel of honor in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 20. It says, but in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor. 21. Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from the latter, he will be vessel for honor, sanctified and useful for the master, prepared for every good work. Amen?
Amen.
This place is telling us that if you cleanse yourself, God will make us vessel of honor. And when He makes us vessel of honor, He will prepare us for His work.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
And my topic today that I'm going to speak to you on is a role of a woman in church growth. What is your role in church growth? What is my role? You may think that I'm a woman, I'm not a pastor. What do I need about church growth? What concerns me? It concerns you 100%.
Amen.
Once you give your life and you are born again, that is the day you got the mantle. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And God is then will prepare you for His good work. Amen.
Amen.
Quickly before I go on, we're going to look into what is role. the role of a woman in the church grows. What is role? Role is the function performed by or played by a person in a particular situation. Your function in this church. What role do you play every day when you come in? Amen?
Amen.
A role is a prescribed or expected behavior associated with a particular position or status or in a group of organization. Amen?
Amen.
Your behavior. What is your behavior in the church? Is your behavior increasing the church or decreasing? Amen?
Amen.
Sometimes our behavior decreases unknowingly and unknowingly. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When we move forward, you see how it is. And a role is a job, position, duty, responsibility. Once you are in a church, as a sister, you are born again, you got a role to do. You got a duty, you got a job. Like with your job description in your place of work.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
Because God is our first employer. And is the greatest employer.
Yes.
And is the greatest employer, we must not go against his policy. Amen?
Amen?
But nowadays we are scared of not to be sacked. You won't go against the policy of your work because you don't want to be sacked. But God will not sack us. Say, God will not sack me.
God will not sack me.
Amen?
Amen.
And God will not make me to be redundant.
Yes.
God will not make me to be redundant.
God will not make me to be redundant.
You know many people are in the church, but they are redundant.
Yes.
Some people, they can't even preach their child. Oh, why me? I'm not the pastor, and I'm not the pastor's wife. Then you will see why you should do it. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Role is a specific activity or obligation which they are held accountable when they assume or assign a role on a project. Once you come to the church, God, you gave your life, God told you, he said, go ye unto the world and preach the gospel. Amen?
Amen.
All of us must go ye. Every day you must go ye. If you don't speak to somebody in the day, you should be scared.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because you know what God told us? He said, if you see the bad person that is doing a wrong thing, you did not advise them. You did not tell them to deceive from their wrong way. He said, if they should die in that condition, I will require their blood from your hand.
Mm-hmm.
It's in Ezekiel, because I've got only 30 minutes to talk, so I can't be opening. Amen?
Amen.
Do you want, how many blood do you think God would have required from your hand? The blood of your neighbor or your co-worker? I'm too scared. That was scares me most.
Yeah.
If I don't talk to people, I don't go and preach, I'll be scared. Somebody passed by, you sit by you at the bus, the bus. If you don't talk, God will require the blood of that person from you. He may get out and it's church. Then you go to hell. And you are sat with this person for how many minutes? For even 2 hours on the coach, you never talk.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The role of a woman in church growth. Amen.
Amen.
You got a big role to play. Amen.
Amen.
Every born again woman is in the church will be accountable for the growth of the church. As your pastor is accountable for the growth of this church, the same of individual person is accountable. Don't say it doesn't concern me, it concerns you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Jesus died for us, and once you give your life, you've taken the job. The day you gave your life, that was the day they employed you. Amen?
Amen?
And they gave you your job description of go ye unto the world. That's your first job description. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 If we open our Bible, so 2 Peter 1 says, it says, wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, ye shall never fall. Amen?
Amen?
If you don't take the calling of God, you will fall. But if you do them, the Bible says you will never fall. Sometimes we pray, our prayer is not answered because we are not doing the work of God.
Amen.
Amen? Amen. Because you don't even preach. You've forgotten why you are here. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Christianity journey is not an easy journey. But it is easy if you know who your God is. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So it's not to come and dance and go away. Amen. How many people have you spoken to?
Amen.
Have you added to the kingdom of God? Have you added to the church of God? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
To be able to do this job, you need to be transformed. Amen?
Amen.
Transformation affects your whole life. It will affect your character. Transformation will affect your conduct, your lifestyle, your relationship with people. We make the church to grow. Amen?
Amen?
Some people, they don't even know how to greet. I'm sorry, this is preaching. Because when I preach, you will not call me back again, but I said it too. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some people don't greet. They come to the church, they're so frowning. Immediately they finish, they take their bag. I don't want to associate. Who tell you that? How are you going to associate in heaven when you don't associate now? Say me. Oh, I don't want people to drag me into trouble. I don't want to. It's because you are sorting me to be dragged. If you don't want to be dragged, you won't be dragged. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Once you are transformed, then the work begins. Amen?
Amen?
So before you can increase the church of God, you have to be born again.
Yeah.
Because what you don't have, you can't give it. If you are not born again, many people even born again, they don't know why they are born again. Why are you born again? It's not because of miracle. To make heaven. Amen?
Amen.
When you are, if you are seeking to make heaven, the Bible says, so it said that seek you the kingdom of God first. All other things shall be added. But what do we do nowadays? We look for the all other things.
That's true.
Amen?
Amen.
What God promised that it will be added. If you are from Africa, when you buy something, they give you jara, they give you, you know what I mean? They say, okay, if it's a 5 for, they do it here. If it's 5 for, they may say, okay, come and take it. 5 to 10 pounds, they say, take 6. They give you extra. We are looking for the extra. We don't look for the main thing.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Amen?
An extra is crumble.
Mm.
It's nothing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God will help all of us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You must get there, my sisters.
Amen.
We are women. We are our role. As you are playing your role at home, you play your role in the church. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
As you are playing this role at home, you play it in the church.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
And how can you be play your role to increase the church of God? You must have the Holy Spirit. Amen?
Amen?
You must have the Holy Spirit. Because when the Holy Spirit is lacking, you can't do nothing. That is why we rise and fall. I will not do it again, I will do it again. I won't do it, I don't know. I've changed, yo. I pastor, I'll be coming every week. Now, you see me, I'll be coming for the midweek service. I will continue to come.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, after 2 times, you won't see my sister again. Why? Oh, it's my baby. Because we haven't got the Holy Spirit.
That's it. That's
some people, their baby are sick. They will have, they tell me, my baby, oh, mommy, my baby is sick. They give my baby antibiotics. That's why I'm not coming to the church. Who tells you? Your baby that is still 1 year old. Put the baby in the car and be coming. The baby is not going to walk to the church. So why does it stop you from coming? Is it working? You can carry the baby to the church. Antibiotics give the baby when you get to the church. Even though you can go and give it at the back there. My baby is hot, I can't come. I want the baby to sleep. It's because you yourself don't want to come.
Mm.
It's not the baby.
Mm.
Because you go to carry the baby in the pram. So why does it need to be? And you will get fresh air when you are coming on the road. So why do you need to carry the baby at home? And you are looking at the baby. And when it's not that you are at home praying for this baby, oh. It has stopped you from coming to the church. And will you go and do evangelism? No. Because you are staying at home looking at the face of your baby. And with that, you are washing the telly. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God will help all of us.
Amen.
You need Holy Ghost to do the job. Amen.
Amen.
If you see Genesis 1 and 2, Jesus, God, before God created the whole world, he started with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit hovered. The Holy Spirit went before Jesus, God. Then the creation started. That is why before you can increase the church, you can bring to people, before you can bring people to the church, before you can make people to stay in the church, you must have the Holy Spirit yourself.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Thank you,
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
It's because we are lacking the Holy Spirit. That's why we can't preach.
That is it.
And secondly, even before Jesus Christ started, before he started the work that he came to do. Amen?
Amen.
Matthew 3:16, he said, as soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the waters. At that moment was opened heaven, and saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting him. And a voice from heaven said, this is my son, whom I love, with whom I am well pleased. Before Jesus started his own mission in this world, the Holy Spirit descended on him. Amen?
Amen.
No wonder we went out, nobody come to, we preach, nobody answered. Holy Ghost did not go with us. It's not in us. It's not there before us. God started the creation with the Holy Ghost. Jesus Christ himself started with the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So before you can increase the church, you need the Holy Ghost. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, this topic is a long topic, but we have to rush. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to, if you open your Bible, so Luke 24, verse 49. Amen.
Amen.
Before even the apostles started work, before they started work, I read from verse 20. Behold, I said, behold, because I'm in a hurry, I don't want to start from the far. Behold, I said the promise of my Father for you, but tarry in the city of Jerusalem until you are endued with power from on high. He told the apostle, don't go and start the work yet. Stay until you are endued with power. Tarry in Jerusalem. Until you don't get the power, don't go out and start to preach. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen?
They stayed there until the Holy Spirit descended on them on the Pentecost day. That was why they could go out and preach the gospel.
Mm.
Amen?
Amen.
Peter was so timid, he was so scared when they wanted to kill Jesus. When the Holy Spirit descended on him, he went out preaching. They don't even care anymore now. Because it wasn't them. Amen?
Amen.
The Holy Ghost has come in. Yes. And the Holy Ghost is the one leading them. That is why today, we don't have much time to pray, but another day, maybe when you come tomorrow, you need Holy Ghost. We have to pray Holy Ghost. When the Holy Ghost is abiding in you and in me, we'll go out there, people will follow you. Mm. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
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 We need the Holy Ghost and to work in our lives in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Amen.
There is a principle we need to abide before we can do the work. The work of God. In John 15:5, he said, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Amen?
Amen.
Apart from me, you can do nothing. So we need Jesus Christ to abide in us. When he abides in us, we can do much. He said that you bear much fruit. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
When you abide, you bear much fruit. then the Holy Ghost will be moving in you. The Holy Ghost will direct you. The Holy Ghost will teach you. The Holy Ghost will speak through you. You will not be shy again. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. You just want to do the work. You just want to work for God. You just want to work for God. And when you have the Holy Spirit in you, my sisters, it is then you have what? When you have the Holy Spirit, you have the fruit of the Spirit. Whoever that has not got the Holy Spirit, you cannot have the fruit of the Spirit that will retain people in your church. Even though if you invite them, if you bring 10 people to church every Sunday, if you haven't got the Holy Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit, they won't remain. Because you won't have the right attitude to keep them. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That is why when the Holy Spirit in you is no longer you that live it.
Yes.
That's in Galatians 2:20. He said, it is no longer I that live it, but Christ that live it in me. It is no longer I that live it, but Christ that live it in me. When Christ lives in you, you do things according to Christ.
Yes.
People will say Christ in you.
Yes.
Even in your place of work, they want to know where you worship.
Yes.
You don't need to preach them. People will be preaching to them, to themselves through you.
Yes.
They look at you, they preach to themselves, they want to follow you. Yes. They will ask to come and teach me things.
Uh-huh.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But if the Holy Ghost is not there, when you are like them at work, who is going to follow you to your church? Nobody. They don't want to come. If they mention, they say, do you want to come with Sister A? I don't want to mention him. He said, is she a Christian? And you've been in the church for 20 years. Someone is asking, is she a Christian? Because they haven't seen any fruit in you. Yes! No fruit of the Spirit in you. Praise God. If you have the Spirit, fruit of the Spirit, you use it to retain people in the church.
That's it.
In Galatians 5:22, that's where we have all the fruits of the Spirit. Because of my time, I just rushed through them. You know, fruit of the Spirit, we have love. Amen?
Amen.
If you have love, you love everyone around you. You know, if you love someone with agape love, the love of God, if the person offends you, you will forgive the person before they say sorry. You will look at my sister, you will know that it's not my sister that offended me, it's the devil.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
Do you know when the devil wants to put two heads together? It will enter one sister. The sister will say, it will say something to you. Instead of you to know that this is the devil, you too, you will answer back. Once you answer back, that's it, the devil will gain the road. Amen?
Amen?
Then we'll tell you to tell her, what does she think she is? Then you say, what does she think she is? Is it because we are coming to this church? The devil will be telling you. Then you'll be thinking in your brain, yes, because I'm coming. What does the pastor call me? Does she see there's no church around my house? Then you start to think. Then, midway they call you, you switch off your phone. Listen. You switch off your phone. You that switch off your phone, tell me, how are you going to phone the new sister that has just come to your church? That please, sister, let us pray together. Because you have switched off your phone for the pastor. So even though if you see the sister that was brought to your church last Sunday, you won't even greet her. You are sending people away from the church. You can't reach the church to grow. When you love God, you will meditate in the word of God. The more you read the word of God, he said, keep this my word in your mouth. Meditate on it day and night so that you make your ways prosperous. If you don't meditate in the word of God, the devil will put his word, and it's easy for him. You don't even need to open book. Listen,
yes.
If the devil wants to put something in your brain, you need to open book. It will just be pouring in, pa, 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 pa. You'll be acting towards it. Amen?
Amen.
Even at home, some people, you are a Christian, your husband doesn't come to church. Because most, you know it, women start church before their husband.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen?
But if you haven't got the fruit of the Spirit, why will your husband follow you to church? No day. Because he won't see anything in you that will bring say that maybe, my wife has changed you. He will be saying, but you have got you since you have been to the church, I haven't seen any good in you. Amen?
Amen.
Then you will the fruits you will have joy. One of the fruits of the Spirit is joy. The joy of the Lord will fill your hearts. And when you have joy, people will see your face. You are always happy.
Amen.
They want to associate with you.
Yes.
But if you are frowning, they don't want to. You scare people away. Even when you enter the church, the next person you sit with, because you are unhappy, you don't greet her. And you know that you mean to offend the person, but because you haven't got no joy. And the person just finished early, he's going. Next time they will call her. Oh, I don't like that your church. Nobody greets. I've heard this several times. People don't greet. And they will stay at home. So church cannot grow with our attitude unless we change. Tell yourself I will change.
I will change.
Tell yourself I will change.
I will change.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Tell yourself you will change.
I will change.
Then the next one is peace. You must have peace with all men. Peace with your neighbor. Some people, they don't greet their next door neighbor. It was like a story. A man wanted to go and preach in China. He prepared everything. Then he went to God and prayed. Father, I'm going to this China because they don't believe. People are doing things on the ground. I'm going there to preach the gospel. I want people to the Lord. And God said, my dear, listen. You bought tickets, you are going to Ghana, China. What for? The Chinese man next to your dog. Have you preached to him? Because the next dog Shiny man, they've never greeted him. Now you need to buy a ticket. God said you don't need ticket to play for a China. Start with this.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We can do it from. We can start from home. Start from your neighborhood. Great people. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Sorry, is my time finished?
No.
1 minute.
Not yet.
Amen.
Amen.
Long suffering. We have to suffer for long.
Yes.
If you haven't got no long suffering, you can't increase the church of God. Amen.
Amen.
You must endure. Endure. Even though know that you are going to heaven. If you see all those people, all the apostles, none of them had it easy.
Yeah.
So when you yourself, you're not going to have it easy.
Amen.
So because this church is not good, you run away. The next, in 2 years, in 6 months time, you are in another church. I says, I'm no more going to that church. Oh. Then you, the way you are going to. Any church you go to, my sisters, that there are human beings there, you will always be offended.
Yes.
Hey.
Yes.
Hey.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Human being,
yes.
You always be offended. So from there, you'll be going from church to church.
Yes,
yes, because they will offend you.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When you have no suffering, and when you preach to people, don't think the person you speak to will give their life in a day. No suffering. Keep on praying for them. If you give them, they don't want to answer. Leave them and go and pray. At the time you can speak to them again, speak. There's one example. They say this man, Stephen Hill, is dead now. He used to be a great man of God. The wife, the man that won that, the wife of Stephen Hill, an old man. That man was a preacher of the gospel. He's just a member of the church, not a pastor, but he know the meaning of soul winning. There will be joy in heaven for one soul you win. This man always went to this woman, said, give your life. The man said, the woman said, oh, did they answer? Do you know? This old man went to this woman, this lady, she was a lady there before she got married. 2 years, for 2 years. She went to her house every Saturday for 2 years before she gave her life. Every Saturday for 2 years.
Yes.
That's to get one soul.
Yes.
Can you do that?
Yes.
Now, when that woman, when the widow woman now. She got married to Stephen Hill. You know how many soldiers won? The only person that this man worked for 2 years. Mm. They got a big church. Mm. The man was going. One day, he got to their house, they flew from that compound. Ah, Baba said, what? How will I get this lady? Then Holy Ghost start to direct. Say, Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
I need you.
I need you.
Just tell me. So increase the church.
So increase
the church. I need you.
I need
to play my role right.
I need you.
You know this, Baba. Holy Ghost said, come, continue, you get her. Mm. Holy Ghost start to direct. Go to road. This road. She started to move. And until she got to the door of this, my lady. And the lady was so glad that Baba would not come again. Because she won't know our house. Every Saturday. What's wrong? Kaka. Hello? Who opened the door? The lady. He said, how do you know my house? She said, it's the Holy Spirit. That was the day she decided that, yes, I have to give my life.
Amen.
2 years, every Saturday.
Hallelujah.
My sister, can you do that?
No.
Want to be tired? We say, who is she? Is she the only one? She's too proud. You start to decorate her. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God will help us.
Amen.
You must have gentleness.
Yes.
When you are gentle, is then you'll be vessel of honor.
Amen.
If you are shut, then you get to reveal market is sister A that is fighting. You can't be a vessel of honor. You can't increase anywhere. Because if you fall with somebody in the market before, and the person get to this church and found you, I'm sure they won't come back again. Mm-hmm. Or is that day you are the one that is even, you are the usher. You are collecting offering. This is the person you fought with before. Somebody invited the person to your church. Then you collected your offering basket. Now you go and give it to. Who say is this? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord will help us.
Amen.
You must have goodness. Goodness is part of the fruit of the Spirit.
Mm.
When you have goodness, you have a good character to people. Amen?
Amen.
You do good. You see somebody, you want to give them something. You look at your sister, wasn't God to want to help them. Amen?
Amen.
Some people, they don't know how to do that. I'm not their slave. I don't want anybody to use me. If you are a preacher, they must use you. If you want to get soul, they must use you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And faith. You must have faith. If you don't have faith, you can't do the job. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Faith. You're thinking, I look at this person, can he? I don't think she can give the life. He can answer me. He won't give us life. One day I was inside the bus. I got trust in my hand. I was going around. I entered the bus. Immediately I entered the bus, I look at the face of those people there. I said, I don't want to start to talk now. Let the bus move a little bit before I start to talk. It's because maybe Holy Spirit was gone then. I didn't talk. The second bus stop, I didn't talk. We got to the bus, third bus stop, God replaced me. Somebody just entered the bus. A man just came in. Immediately we are moving. He said, everybody, good afternoon, good morning. He looked at the sister. Sister, you are very beautiful. You are good for heaven. You must not go to hell. He started to talk to everyone in that bus. He started to talk to her. Because I didn't do the work, God brought somebody. Yes, he replaced me immediately because I haven't got no faith to stand up. Do you know 2 weeks, I wasn't well. I was just down. I was praying. He preached to me too. Because I didn't do it. God can replace anybody. He showed me there. He replaced me immediately in my presence. Now, can I preach again? When she came and started, I can't do it again. I was just going, have mercy. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Right.
Temperance. You must have self-control. Amen?
Amen.
Whatever they do to you, listen, but slow to talk.
Yes.
Process the word in your brain before you talk. Because those people that have anger, when they talk finish, they're like, oh, I couldn't have said it. And you said it, that may send people away from the church. So to increase the growth of the church, you must have the fruits of the Spirit.
Amen.
That's the only way you can make it.
Thank you, Jesus.
And God will help us, love us.
Amen.
To be able to work for Him.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we thank you, Lord. We worship you.
Amen.
In Jesus.